Thank you for joining us. Tonight we're learning more about a proposed tax increase in St. Paul that could go towards roads and park improvements.
Whether or not it happens is up to voters next Tuesday. Chief political reporter John Croman takes a closer look at the issue in tonight's top story.
St. Paul has a lot of catching up to do when it comes to basic upkeep on roads and city recreation centers.
We can make our streets safer, have our shared infrastructure be more climate friendly, and enjoyable for all who seek to work, play, and live here.
Supporters of ballot question one say that raising the local sales tax by one penny on the dollar will generate nearly $1 billion over the next 20 years that can be dedicated to catching up.
I'm asking my friends, my neighbors, my community that we vote yes.
The ballot spells out how the money would be divvied up, $738,000 for streets and roads, $240,000 for parks and rec and associated bonding costs.
To have all these small businesses carrying a 10% sales tax when people can easily drive to the suburbs, it just wasn't right.
City Council Member Jane Prince opposes the ballot question because it includes new facilities, and part of the money can be used to help pay for big ticket items like the proposed river balcony.
It's one thing to build new capital projects, but it takes property taxes to staff, operate, and maintain them.
Her fellow council member, Mitra Jalali, calls it a critical investment in the future.
How do we get ahead of these challenges, not just endlessly reacting to them with less and less resource and band-aiding these issues, but to really look at where we are as a community and say, this is our chance to get ahead.
So voters are being asked to tax themselves more on the things they buy in this city, but proponents point out that the sales tax will also capture revenue from people visiting the capital city. So in other words, out-of-towners will also pick up part of this tab. In St. Paul, John Croman, Care 11 News.